स्टूडेंट्स, आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज बर्न्स। सो व्हाट आर बर्न्स? बर्न कैन बी डिफाइंड एज एनी इंजरी दैट रिजल्ट्स फ्रॉम द डायरेक्ट कॉन्टैक्ट और एक्सपोजर टू एनी थर्मल, केमिकल, इलेक्ट्रिकल और रेडिएशन सोर्स। सो बर्न इज अ टाइप ऑफ कोगुलेटिव नेक्रोसिस। Remember for your exam, burn is a coagulative necrosis that is caused by heat transferred from the source to the body. Frostbite, it occurs in the cold countries. It is also a type of coagulative necrosis, but it is caused by extreme degree of cold. What is scald? Scald is a burn that is caused by the moist steam. So remember for your exam, scald is a caused by moist steam. Also remember, burns never occur at temperature less than 44 degrees Celsius. So remember, 70% of cases are in 15 to 35 years age group. Coming to the types of burn. So types, they can be either thermal burns, electrical burns, chemical burns or radiation burns. Pathophysiology of the burns. Number one is the increased capillary permeability that leads to fluid and protein leakage from the intravascular space. Second is the decreased plasma oncotic pressure due to the hypoproteinemia resulting from the loss of protein from the intravascular space. Third is increased capillary hydrostatic pressure that is due to the vasoconstriction or partial blockage of the vessels. Fourth, reduced clearance of fluid and protein from the interstitial space by the lymphatic ducts due to the blockage by platelet aggregates. Fifth, intracellular fluid accumulation due to impaired cell membrane function. And sixth is increased osmotic pressure in the burned tissue. Seventh, increased evaporative water loss. And sixth, depressed myocardial activity. A few important points that you have to remember with the relation of burn patient to the kidney. So maximum water reabsorption by release of ADH from posterior pituitary as a compensatory mechanism. Aldosterone is released to cause maximum sodium reabsorption, and acute tubular necrosis can occur due to the toxin. Injury of kidney can occur due to the myoglobin. So there are three types of burns. Burns could be of three types: primary burn, secondary burn and tertiary burn. So in the primary burn, remember, only epidermis is involved, whereas in secondary burn there is varying depth of dermis, and in the tertiary burn there is involvement of entire depth of epidermis and dermis. So in primary burn, the appearance is like there is erythema and oedema. In secondary burns, the appearance is like blister, soft, waxy, white, pain sensation to needle prick there is present. Whereas in tertiary burn, the area is tough, dry, there is eschar formation and the pain sensation to needle prick is absent. The primary burn, it heals in 3 to 5 days without scar formation. Secondary burn, it heals in 10 to 15 days with hypertrophic scar. Whereas tertiary bun, it heals in 3 to 5 weeks and it always need a split skin graft. Coming to the metabolic response to the burn patient, number one is gluconeogenesis. And glycogenolysis. So remember, these two are increased. Second is lipolysis. It is also increased as the fatty acids are released. They are re-esterified and into triglycerides, resulting in fat accumulation in the body. There is increased proteolysis. So that results in increased production of urea that is excreted in the urine. So remember, the burns patient remember the burn patient requires more than 1 gram per kg per day proteins. Now, how will you manage the burn patient? First aid should be given. The cold water bath should be given. It take away the heat, stabilizes the mast cells and decrease the release of histamine. And thus it decreases the oedema. So there are two types of burns. One could be the partial thickness graft and other is full thickness graft. In the partial thickness, only the superficial layer of skin are destroyed. The epidermis and variable portion of dermis are involved. Since the nerve endings are exposed, it causes severe pain. In full thickness graft, involvement of full thickness of dermis with epidermis is involved. So here the nerves are destroyed, so there will be less pain. So remember, partial thickness graft is associated with severe pain, whereas full thickness graft is associated with lesser pain. Coming to the assessment of extent of burn in terms of body surface area, that is calculated by the rule of 9 or the rule of Wallace. So remember, what is rule of Wallace and rule of 9? According to it, the burns of head and neck, they constitute the 9%. The burns of the upper limb constitute the 9% into 2, that is 18. Burns of anterior trunk, they are 18%. Burns of the posterior trunk, they are the 18%. Burns of the lower limb, front and back of each lower limb is 9%. So total of 18 into 2 is equal to 36%. So the front and back of each lower limb is 9%. So 18 in the 9 in front, 9 in back. So both side, left leg and right leg, total of 36%. And burns of external genitalia constitute 1%. Other chart is the अदर इम्पोर्टेंट चार्ट इज रिमेंबर लर्नड एंड प्राउडर चार्ट दैट इज यूजफुल इन द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ बर्न पेशेंट. Unlike the Wallace rule of 9, the Lund and Browder chart takes into consideration the age of patient. With a decreasing percentage of body surface area for the head and increasing percentage of body surface area for the legs, as the child ages, so it is making it more useful in the pediatric burns. Other is the Palmer method. The patient palms, including the finger, is 1% of their total body surface area. The Jackson's thermal wound theory. So each burned area has three zones of injuries. The inner zone, the middle zone and the outer zone. The inner zone or zone of coagulation is where cellular death occurs. And sustains the most damage. The middle area or zone of stasis has a compromised supply of blood, inflammation and tissue injury, whereas the outer zone or the zone of hyperemia sustains the least damage. A burn patient can develop acute stress ulcers that are known as curling ulcers. So remember for your exam, curling ulcers are acute stress ulcers. So to prevent bleeding, a cold stomach wash is given through the Ryle's tube. Antacid and hydrogen blockers such as ranitidine, they can be given twice a day. Remember, the loss of intravascular fluid will start when the burn size approaches 10 to 15% of total body surface area. When the total body surface area is 25%, loss of fluids will start from the vessels in a remote area also. So after 36 hours, depending upon the urinary output and depending upon the requirement of body, 2 to 3 liter of fluid that can be given per day. The fluid of choice in burn is lactate ringer, that is ringer lactate. Normal saline, it can produce hyperchloremic acidosis, so it is not given. So what is the Parkland formula? So remember the Parkland formula, 4 milliliter percentage of burn into weight in 24 hours. The first half of total volume is given in the first 8 hours, whereas the remaining half of total volume is given over the 16 hours. And in next 24 hours, total volume, half of the first day is given. So remember, do not give colloids in the first 24 hours. Other is the Brucke's formula. So remember the Brucke formula. So according to the Brucke's formula, first half of the total volume is given in first 8 hours and remaining half of total volume given over the 16 hours. So remember the Brucke's formula. Other is the Evans formula. For requirement for the first 24 hours, colloid saline D5. Requirement for the second 24 hours, half of the first 24. Antimicrobial agents that could be applied is silver sulfadiazine, 1% cream, or mefenide acetate, 5 to 10% cream, that is effective against the gram negative and gram positive organisms. So it is the agent of choice for the electrical burns because of its ability to penetrate the thick asher. सिल्वर नाइट्रेट 0.5% एक्वस सोल्यूशन कैन बी गिवन, इट इज बोथ बैक्टीरियोस्टैटिक एंड फंगीसिडल, इट डज नॉट पेनिट्रेट द इशर. द एनल्जीसिया दैट कैन बी गिवन इज मोरफिन सल्फेट, फेंटानाइल, मिथाडोन, हेलोपेरिडोन, लोराजिपाम, मिडाजोलापाम. सो अक्यूट फेज दैट बिगिन्स 48 to 72 hours आफ्टर द बर्न इंजरी. So here the extracellular fluid starts mobilize and starts diuresis. So this phase is complete when the wound is covered by the skin graft or the wounds are healed, and it may take weeks or many months. Ishar begins to separate fairly after injury. The re-epithelization begins at the wound margin and appears as red pink scar tissue. There can be hyponatremia, hypokalemia, or decrease hemocrit. So the management, the goals are to prevent, goals are the prevention of infection and wound care, excision and grafting, pain management, nutritional therapy, physical, psychosocial and occupational therapy. So prevention of infection and wound care should be given. You have to clean and debride the area of necrotic tissue that promotes the bacterial growth. As the burn wounds are frequently monitored for bacterial colonization. So debridement could be natural, mechanical or surgical. So graft that can be used is permanent skin graft, autograft or cultured epithelial autograft. That can be temporary, artificial or synthetic. Autograft, they are harvested from the patient, they are non-antigenic, less expensive, there is decreased risk of infection. Disadvantages are lack of sight and painful. So this is a skin graft measure that is used as an autograft. Permanent skin graft that could be cultured epithelial autograft, a small piece of patient is harvested and grown in a culture medium. So it takes 3 weeks to grow enough for the first graft. This is the cultured epithelial autograft. Temporary skin graft that could be biosynthetic allograft, that is from live or cadaver human donors. So they have best infection control of all biological coverings. The disadvantage that could be disease transmission, including HBV and HIV. Xenograft, graft between the two different species. Porcine is most common. Or fresh frozen or freeze dry graft could be used. Temporary skin graft. So these are the temporary skin graft. Nutritional therapy, high protein and high caloric diet is given to the patient. So the oral route is the best route. Exercise and rehabilitation phase. It starts when the patient's burn wounds are healed. So that occurs from week to month. So the new skin starts to appear, which is flat and pink. Mature healing is reached in 6 months to 2 years. Apply water moistures to prevent dryness and itching. So remember the complications. These are the complications that could occur. There could be infections, contracture, urinary problems, respiratory problems or cardiovascular problems. Curling ulcer, it is an acute gastric erosion resulting from complication from the severe burns when reduced plasma volume leads to ischemia and cell necrosis of the gastric mucosa. These are the curling.